SA.io is one of the most famous mobile games. In this video, we will learn how to make it. For a start, create two objects called A and B for example. A is blue and B is red area. In first SA, we want any of these two areas have some kind of soldier or unit, which their number increases every second. Create an A script named area or whatever you want. Open it, up here define an integer called unit, then increase it by seconds in update void. Because we want the units to increase by number every second, up here define a float named timer and increase it by seconds in update. Then write an if. If timer was greater than 1, unit increases by 1 and timer gets 0. Now drag area script to A and B objects. If you press play, the unit will increase 1 by 1 in each of them. Increasing speed is low a little, so I write 2 times time dot delta time. If you want to display unit numbers below these two area circles, like me, create an empty game object and add a TextMeshPro component to it. Of course, to use it you must already import a TextMeshPro package. Now edit size of text as you want. Don't forget to increase order life from extra settings to prevent being behind other objects. Duplicate text and make it another object's child. Up here use TMPro by writing using TMPro, then down here to display unit number define a TextMeshPro called myNumber or whatever you want. Then write myNumber.text equal to unit.toString. In a start void, equal myNumber.text to 0 to start counting from 0. Now give number of A and B areas to their define a TextMeshPro field in a script. After play you can see units get increased by 1 in every second and their number displays. To recognize clicks, I use onMonStat method. For mobiles, it's better if you use touch orders. I suggest use my way for now. At end, change it to touch if you wanted to. Create an onMonStat void. Before I start writing orders, up here define a manager integer for touch management. Now in onMonStat equal manager to 1. In this way, if you click on any area, that area's manager equals 1. Now we want the touch position, so define a game object called OVG or whatever. Then produce it. After that, define a game object called touchPosition, then equal it to instantiating OBG game object. Now write in update, if manager was equal to 1, position of touchPosition equals to most position or the touch point. For creating the touch point prefab, drag a sprite like a circle towards hierarchy, name it touchPosition and convert it to a prefab by dragging it towards asset section. Now delete its object. Before instantiate, don't forget to add a box collider for both areas and check there is trigger box. Then give prefab to A and B area. Pay attention, you should give touch position prefab to the OBG game object till after produce equals to touch position. Now after play, if you click on any of A or B areas, touch position object must be produced. After click, the object produces, but it doesn't display. Why? Cause Z is negative 10. So open the code, make Z positive 10 and increase its layer. Now if you play again, if you click on any areas, this touch position produces and follows most cursor or touch position. Now we want after taking your finger off the screen or releasing the mouse button, touch position disappears. So create a new void called onMouseUp, which in its job is to recognize releasing mouse button or taking finger off the screen. So in it make the manager 0 and destroy touch position. After play, if you click on any area, touch position produces, follows mouse pointer, and after release the mouse button, it disappears. Now you may ask why we created touch position object. We made it till we can draw a line from first clicked area to another area. Exactly like a SA.io game. Of course you can do it by another ways, but we did it to better understanding. Now to drawing a line between touch point and each area, click on A object and add a line renderer component. Zero position is clicked area position itself and first position is touch position. To specify line renderer color, create a material, then change shader to a sprite. Now give material to line renderer. Change its layer till it comes on the objects. You can change its size too. To change its color, you can change the material color too. Now for drawing a line between touch and area, as long as your hand is on the screen, it means when manager is 1, put touched area position in 0 position section and put touch position in first position section. And when you take off your finger, means in almost up, both positions set as 0. Now give line renderer to B game object too. After play, if you click on any area between that area and touch position, a line draws. Now we want to detect where our finger was when we take it off the screen. Create a new script called touch position, then open it. Up here, define a string called my tag and define a game object called my arrow. Why? Cause we want when we drag our finger on a screen, a script can recognize tag and area of touched positions. Now come back to area script where touch position produces. Equal defined my area game object to this game object and equal defined tag with this game object's tag. In this way, we can detect first touch position in touch position script. Now up here in area script, define an integer called attack. I will tell the reason ahead. Open touch position script again, create an untrigger enter to the void down here. With its job, it to recognize touch position collides with which area.
Look at this. Somebody come look at this.
Now in its right, if tag of what this game object collides was equal to this game object's tag, do nothing. But if it wasn't equal to this game object, equal defined attack to 1. It means when attack equals to 1, you should attack. Again, open area script, write in almost up, if attack equals to 1, equal attack to 2. Now what it means? It means I dragged my hand and it hit enemy's area and I took my hand away. That means attack to that area. So equal attack to 2. Now write in update, if attack equals to 2, attack to that area. Which area? Good question. Up here define a game object called target to detect which area it should attacks. Now come back to touch position script where you put attack equal to 1. Equal define a target to collide a target. I mean other dot game object. In this way a script can recognize who is enemy and who we should attack. Now define two new tags. It doesn't matter what name they be. Then give them to A and B object. Let's go to unit production. When attack equals to 2, units must be instantiated. We do it by enumerator and while. Create an enumerator, write while unit was greater than 0 and by yield return wait for second. Run this while it's 0.3 seconds until units number equals or smaller than 0. Now we just need to produce units one by one. And by each unit production, the number of units decreases by 1. After that, write an if order. If unit equals to 0, make attack 0 till everything comes back to there first. Now in if attack equals to 2 in update, call enumerator, then equal attack to 3, till make this order runs only once. Next job is to prevent continuous unit production when we attack another area or our area is being attacked. For this, define a boolean called canMake. Then write in update if canMake equals to false, timer start increasing and when we wanna attack it mean attack equals to 2, canMake becomes true till units number don't increases. And when unit was equal to 0, it means when all units has been produced. Then set canMake to false so that the units are produced again. Let's go for creating units. Import a circle image or what else, give it a rigid body and collider, then create a new script called unit, drag the script to unit and then make it prefab. Now choose two areas, give this unit to unit prefab which is a spawning object. Now press play, if you drag your hand from an area to another one, units get produced, but they don't move toward another area. To fix this, open units script. Define a target game object up here, then in area script when units get produced, equal instantiate to a game object called you for example. So you can edit anything of it. Now equal units target to area's target. It might be a little complicated, but if you watch again, you will surely understand. Again, in units script in update, make them follow the target. In this way, any unit after produce follows the specified target. Something is missing here. Where the number of units is decreasing one by one, it should be displayed in text. So come back and fix this. Now press play, after you drag your hand from an area to another area, units get produced and move toward that area. Next job is when units enter to enemy area circle, reduce the units in that area and then be destroyed. For this, open the area script, create an untrigger enter to the void to detect collisions. Now scroll up a bit, where units get produced, equal each unit's tag to the area it comes from. Each area collides with two game objects. First one is units and second one is touch position game objects, and should not check its units for collide. So write if colliding game objects tag was not equal to the producer area tag and colliding game objects tag wasn't touch. Don't forget on touch prefab add a tag named touch and select it for sure. If this area hit you anything else, destroy that thing, decrease units number by 1 and display it. Then set can make to true. Why? Cause we want on any collision, units number doesn't increases. First play. As you can see, you can attack from an area to another area and decrease its units number. But after attack, number of enemy units doesn't increases, so you must set can make to false again. Define a float called second timer. Then write in update, if can make was true, increase this second timer 1 by 1. After 3 seconds, second timer becomes 0. Also can make becomes false. Now, for when we attack to another area to make our area units number doesn't increases like in the original game, set second timer to 0 in make unit section. First play, now we can attack from our area to another area. Well, let's work with units collision together in the middle of the way. Define a collision void, I mean on trigger enter 2D. Write if tag of the things that unit collide was not this unit tag. After destroying them, destroy yourself, and if name of what you collide was unit. Why? Cause first we want units, don't destroy friendly units. Second, they only destroy units. So open area script again, where units get produced, change name of produced units to unit. Now cause it's possible touch position collides with units, in its script where you manage collisions, do all stuff when name the things you collide was not unit. To changing ownership of an area, open area script in collision section, add first if, add another if. If units number was more than 0, write last commands in the body of this if. Below it in else, you call area tag to tag of colliding units. In this way, tag of this area changes and becomes ours. Another point is about sending units to friendly areas. For this, in area script at collision section, write if tag of what you collide was friendly tag and its tag wasn't equal to touch, run commands. Before it, in unit script, define a string called sender till you can put name of the area which sends these units. So you must go where you instantiate units, equal the area name to this sender. Come back to area script again, where you defined a new if. Write in it, if sender of unit that you collide was not equal to name of this area. Why? Cause an area can only help friendly areas, not itself. In if body destroy units and by any destroy increase units number by 1. Display them and set can make to true. Exactly, you should do like this scenario in touch position too. So open the touch position script, up here define a new string called my area name for example. Then again open area script where you instantiate touch position, equal my area name to name of this area. Again open touch position script, in collision section you need only one if with two conditions. First says name of what this object collides should not equal to unit. Second says name of area that this object collides should not be my area name. Till when player's hand is on an area, don't send units to that area. Only sends units to neighbor areas. Let's test. After play, attack to B area. As you can see, as soon as its units become less than 0, its tag changes to area A. And any units comes to it, adds to units number. If you send units toward it, for each number, units number increases by 1. Let's work on changing color. Open unit script, up here define a public color 32 called CL for example. Then open area script again. Where units get produced, give any color you want to the defined color, I mean CL. You can write a color code like what I wrote. Now any unit has the color of our area. Only you should go where you change tag of another area. I mean after attack and take over another area, change its color to CL. Now as you can see, if you attack to another area, that's color change. Let's create more enemies and more areas. Choose different colors for each of them and add different tags for them. Now we want after attack in addition to changing around color, its center color changes too. So open unit script, define another color 32 called inside CL. Again open area script, where you specify unit color, specify inside CL too. Now to manually change the color from scene, up here define two public colors, called for example CL1 and CL2. After that down here put CL1 instead of unit CL and equal inside CL to CL2. Define a sprite renderer called inside. where you change any area's color to CL, change inside's color to inside CL. Now choose each area. Put any area's color in CL1 and put center color in CL2. Don't forget to give the center of each area to inside a sprite. It's done. Now it doesn't matter how many enemies you have. Just keep these two things in mind. 1. Name of areas shouldn't be like each other. And 2. Don't forget give tag to new areas. If any area attacks another area, it can overtake it and make enemy's area color like itself. Now we have made base of set.io. Things that left from game are AI, choosing multiple areas for attack, 4 units in one line unit production, and touch, and maybe another points which we will put them in the next tutorial. Don't forget like and subscribe us, thank you.